If you could travel at the incredible speed of 1 light-year per second, you would embark on an extraordinary journey across the universe. Beginning on Earth, after just 1 second, you'd find yourself at the edge of the solar system. 4 seconds later, you'd reach the nearest star system, Alpha Centauri, home to 3 stars in the setting of the three-body problem. 8 seconds in, you'd reach Sirius, the brightest star in the night sky. At 40 seconds, you'd arrive at 55 Cancri E, a planet encrusted with diamonds, rubies, and sapphires. In 10 minutes, you'd reach the habitable zone of Kepler-22b, though today's technology would take millions of years to reach it. After 14 minutes, you'd come to Regal, a blue supergiant shining 110,000 times brighter than the Sun. 1.5 hours later, you'd encounter UY Scuti, a star so massive it could hold billions of suns. 2 hours in, you'd find the stellar nursery of the Pillars of Creation, where newborn stars emerge from nebulae that reach into deep space like fingers, often called the Hand of God. At the 5-hour mark, you'd arrive at VY Canis Majoris, another massive star with a radius large enough to contain 130 million billion Earths. Within a day, you'd reach the edge of the Milky Way, glimpsing its 400 billion stars. After 29 days, you'd enter Andromeda, our neighboring galaxy, which may merge with the Milky Way in 4 billion years. At 115 days, you'd break through the local group of galaxies, a cluster of over 50 ancient galaxies. 3 years into your journey, you'd reach the edge of the Virgo Supercluster, home to 5,000 galaxies. And within 16 years, you'd exit the Laniakea Supercluster, with its feather-like formation of galaxies. A century into your voyage, you'd arrive near Ton 6118, containing the largest known black hole, with a mass equal to 66 billion suns. After 320 years, you'd exit the Great Wall, the largest known structure, covering over 10% of the observable universe. Finally, after 1,000 years, you would reach the edge of the observable universe, a border beyond which lies either nothing or endless stars. At this limit, the vastness of the universe underscores the smallness of human existence.